everybody, this is 17005 Skyla, and if you haven't guessed by the headband and the stuffed animal, this video is about my cats Dragon and Dot. Now Dragon was my first cat, like he's my first cat. Our family has had cats before. My father had a cat named Tootsie, which he had since she was a kitten, and my mother had adopted a cat named Socks. Once a family couldn't keep him anymore, she took him in. And I had lived with them as an infant, but I don't really remember them. But I always begged for a cat. I was an only child, I still am, unfortunately. And so I knew what it was like to feel lonely. What had happened was that I went to the store, and by the window there was already a little container with a bunch of little kitties in their little pen, and all the cats there were exactly the same breed except for one, and that was Dragon. And when I saw that he was all by himself with all these other cats who were pretty much the same, and he being all by himself with no other kittens like him, I instantly knew that he was the cat that I was meant to have. And since then, he has literally been my best friend throughout all these years, and I love him very much. He's much older now, so he doesn't really go out and play or do anything like that. Most of the time, he's just sleeping or hiding, so I don't have much footage of him. But I did used to film him back when I was first making my YouTube channel, when I was maybe like 9-10 years old. I used to follow him around with my first camcorder and make a fake Australian accent and document his life. This only lasted for maybe 4 episodes or 3 episodes, but nonetheless, it was something that I very much enjoyed, and hopefully I'll be able to post more cat videos up of Dragon, because I do miss following them with a camera. Now Dot is 1 year old. He's just over 1 year old, actually, and he is actually Dragon's son. Back around in 2012, my neighbors had actually adopted their own cat named Shorty. Shorty was pretty rambunctious and mischievous and crazy, but my family had grown to love her very, very much. Our neighbor's family and my family are connected in that in my apartment building, we have terraces that connect different apartments together, but we have a little barrier that separates them so our pets don't get confused and end up walking into each other's apartment. However, the kitten, Shorty, back when she was a kitten, because she grew up, she actually was smart enough to climb around the railing and make it inside of our apartment whenever she was hungry and our neighbors weren't home to feed her. But apparently one day when our families were both out, I guess at the same time, Dragon had gotten her pregnant, and things had never been the same since then. As time went on, her belly got huge and it was drooping all over the place. And she would visit our apartment every once in a while, and Dragon would make sure she was okay with her little babies, and we would feed her, make sure that she was alright since she was taking care of her little litter inside of her belly. But when she had finally given birth, the family had actually went and shoved her and the rest of the kittens inside of a little pen, which we still have, and told us that they couldn't handle raising those kittens anymore. We took them in because we couldn't let a family of kittens and their mother go out into the street. And we had raised them for a few weeks, and it was honestly one of the most exciting times of my life. And this time of raising the kittens was really a time that I will just never ever forget. It was the cutest thing ever, and I would always run around to my friends and say, "I'm a grandmother," and of course they would get confused because I was referring to my cat's child. But nonetheless, it counts because I consider Dragon as my son, and so that means Dot's my grandson. Time went on and we had to give the cats away. I had to pick one cat because our family couldn't afford to take care of the entire family, including Dragon and Shorty. So we had given Shorty and the rest of the litter of six to a little shelter, which said that they would take care of them and then transfer the family onto a bigger organization, which would prepare them for adoption. And so I had picked Dot, and I'm happy I picked Dot. I think if I had to choose all over again, I would pick him once more. And if you want to check out more videos that are like this one, or at least inspired me to make this video, I will include them in the description. And thanks for watching. I'll be signing out. By the way, this is chocolate chip. I got him from the Bronx Zoo with my godmother, and I love him. He's super cuddly, and yeah. I also have a pet rock that I keep inside this thing. His name is Jesus. See, that's Jesus. Sometimes I water him. I don't know why, but... It's okay. He's right. I'm sorry. Bye, guys.